Thanks for joining us tonight at 6. We start right now with some developing news about a state lawmaker who was arrested.
And investigators say he stole hundreds of thousands of dollars and then lost the money gambling.
Channel 3 New Haven Bureau Chief Matt McFarlane is live right outside West Haven City Hall, uncovering the incredible details of exactly what happened here. Matt?
No, Mark and Aaron, after the FBI showed up here at West Haven City Hall 2 weeks ago, plenty of folks here in town thought it was only a matter of time until someone was arrested. Well, that happened today, and it turns out it's a state rep who also happens to work here.
Sir, you learned a lesson about stealing?
If he did, State Rep Michael DeMasa wasn't about to say on his way out of U.S. District Court. DeMasa, who works as the administrative assistant for West Haven City Council, is now facing one charge of federal wire fraud, accused of billing the city for hundreds of thousands of dollars in COVID relief funding for work he allegedly never did.
Yeah, I'm really not going to comment on the case. It would be inappropriate at this time. As you know, the matter was simply continued. This is the first step in a process.
According to court paperwork, the 30-year-old DeMasa, along with a partner, created a consulting business back in January, allegedly billing West Haven and its COVID-19 grant department for what it described as legal, lobbying, and site work. From in or about February 2021 through September 2021, a total of $636,783.70 was paid to the Compass Investment Group by the city of West Haven. But according to investigators, West Haven's health director never used, selected, approved, or otherwise engaged Compass Investment Group for any work or services. So just what happened to the money that was supposed to help the city during the pandemic? Well, the criminal complaint goes on to allege that DeMasa made 21 cash withdrawals from his business's account, totaling more than $178,000, and then made thousands of dollars worth of cash buy-ins of gaming chips at the Mohegan Sun Casino. As a result, the governor says the state's Office of Policy and Management is already hiring folks to do a forensic audit as to what went down in West Haven.
The public service is a public trust, and we're putting a lot of resources to work, and I think people have a right to make sure that those resources are going to the people in need.
Now DeMasa is free on $250,000. Bonnie, we're also told he was instructed to continue with treatment for gambling. His role with the state legislature, Democratic leadership has stripped him of his assignments and his committees. As for his role here at West Haven City Hall, we reached out to Mayor Nancy Rossi, but she did not respond. We're live with the Mobile Newsroom in West Haven. Matt McFarlane, Channel 3, Eyewitness News.